Hello again. I'm Steve Miller, a physician and chief clinical officer at Cigna. It's hard to believe that it's been a full year with COVID-19 as a constant, invisible threat to our daily lives. Like many of you, I'm feeling the pandemic fatigue and ready to enjoy many things I used to do, sporting events, traveling, and hugging my family and friends, to name a few. The good news is that we are about to turn a corner in our fight against COVID-19. As new vaccines become available and distribution continues to accelerate, there is reason to have hope. However, in this dynamic environment, confusion remains related to the safety and efficacy of COVID-19 vaccines. In this video, I'm going to do my best to help address and explain some of the most common misperceptions. First, I want to talk about the concerns related to the speed of development for the available COVID-19 vaccines. The fact that we were able to bring first COVID-19 vaccines to market in only a matter of months is an incredible scientific achievement. Are they safe? My answer to this question is unequivocally yes. In fact, I personally participated in one of the clinical trials. In part, this success is due to scientists' ability to quickly isolate and sequence the virus's genetic code, which allows us to begin working on the vaccines promptly. And the methods used to create the vaccines have been applied before or were in development for years. This gave researchers a leg up in development once the virus was sequenced. Together with global support and resources from industry and government, researchers were able to gather data more quickly by operating trials in an overlapping schedule. To be clear, no steps in the clinical trial designs were skipped. Turning now to vaccine side effects. Side effects may vary by vaccine, but we have recently seen that with two dose regimens, many people may experience greater symptoms after receiving the second dose. These side effects tend to include mild fever, muscle pain, and general fatigue, which can be treated with over-the-counter pain relievers or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen. Remember, no drug is totally free from side effects. There have been reported cases of allergic reactions or acute immune thrombocytopenia, a disorder that causes you to have low platelets, which help you prevent bleeding. I want to underscore, serious side effects like these have been studied and are extremely rare, with less than 1 per 1 million doses reported. And compared to the severity of coronavirus, which has killed more than 500,000 people in the United States and is causing long-term complications for many more, the benefits clearly outweigh the risk. I encourage anyone who has previously experienced side effects with other medications or vaccines, or anyone with pre-existing conditions, to make the vaccination site aware when you visit. Along with side effects, some people have questions about how COVID-19 vaccines actually work. To be clear, the vaccine does not give you COVID-19 or change your DNA in any way. The Pfizer and Moderna vaccines do not contain the virus. They are mRNA vaccines which instruct your muscles to make spike protein, which your immune system recognizes. The J&J vaccine is a non-replicating viral vector vaccine, which is similar to our annual flu shot. Both of these types of vaccines have turned out to be extremely well tolerated and safe. Beyond side effects, there have been concerns about the potential impact that the vaccine may have on a woman's fertility or pregnancy. Thus far, there have been no signals to raise concerns. However, it has not yet been formally studied. Pfizer has just initiated a trial of its vaccine in pregnant women, and we should have more information in the future. Keep in mind that COVID-19 can have potentially serious complications on pregnancy and the mother's health. Any woman who is pregnant, breastfeeding, or planning to become pregnant should consult with their doctor prior to getting vaccinated. We are working towards a return to normal social and economic activity, but it will take time. In the meantime, remember that every one of us must do the right thing to safely get through this final stretch. Even if you've been vaccinated, safety precautions are needed until we reach herd immunity. None of us are safe until we're all safe. properly wear a mask that covers your mouth, nose, and chin every time you're around someone outside of your household bubble. Frequently wash or sanitize your hands and practice social distancing and avoid gatherings with others, especially indoors. We're all tired of being careful. We miss the way things used to be, but please stay vigilant. Know that the vaccines are safe and key to moving forward. Thank you and stay safe.